Sir, first of all, I condemn the way both the bills have been brought to this House without the scrutiny of the Standing Committee or the Select Committee of the Parliament. And the government is repeatedly bulldozing the parliamentary practice so far maintained by this House and the other House. Sir, secondly, I oppose both the bills because, according to me, both the bills are draconian bills because there is no reasonable nexus between the objectives of the bill, as has been mentioned here, and the provisions of the bill. So that way it is totally draconian. So in the morning, I requested the Honorable Chairman that some time should be extended because these are crucial bills. Those who understand about arbitration, these are all alternative dispute redressal mechanism, and this is not a coffee machine that someone will push the button and coffee will come. This is something more than that. And I was given to understand the time will be extended. And I, when I requested you at 2 o'clock, from one member, Mr. Bhupendra Jadhav from the ruling party, he agreed for extension. From the main opposition, Mr. Anand Sharma, he also agreed. But unfortunately, the minister objected. Anyway, he has the right to object. 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 No, later means what? After 6 o'clock, it will be considered. So those who will be speaking before 6 o'clock, their cases will not be considered. Those will be speaking after 6 o'clock, their cases will be considered. That is the outcome. That is the criteria. Sorry. Anyway. Admitted, accepted. But both the bills are draconian. The bills, the objective says only two things. To provide for the establishment and incorporation, and I'm talking about the first bill, New Delhi International Arbitration Center, for the purpose of creating an independent and autonomous regime for institutionalized arbitration. And nothing reflects from the bill that it will be independent and autonomous. How? I'm coming to that. But before that, there is a short background of this bill, why this bill has been brought. On 2nd March 2009, the Government of India promulgated ordinance for setting up New Delhi Arbitration Center, and on the same day, Joint Secretary and Legal Advisor of the Law Ministry was appointed the custodian of the International Center for Alternative Dispute Resolution, ICADR in short, which was taken over by the government even without any consultation with the Chief Justice of India, who was the chairman of ICADR, on the same day, the day the ordinance was promulgated. Secondly, sir, my question is, why so much hurry? The ordinance was challenged before Delhi High Court. And the appointment of arbitrator was, appointment of the custodian was stayed. Government thereafter filed review petition, and stay, which was earlier granted by the court, was vacated on 16th May. The case is listed for further hearing on 25th July, yet to come, this month, 25th July. And government has no patience to wait for the outcome of the judicial proceedings. This government has no respect for the judiciary. Again, it has been established. This is the hurry. But what court will do, they do not know. So this is the hurry. Sir, there is another angle. The Learned Council, appearing on behalf of the government, she contended before the court that we have committed before the World Bank by 19th May, we shall come out with some positive result regarding ease of doing business, which includes the arbitral institution. So, this government is dictated upon by the World Bank. That is the main reason, and that is the reason for the hurry. Sir, the government speaks about the Sri Krishna Committee. So the minister was telling so many things about Sri Krishna Committee. But so far, this bill is concerned, this New Delhi Center of Arbitration, two eminent members of that Sri Krishna Committee, Justice S. Ravindra Bhat, former Justice of Delhi High Court, and Mr. K. K. Venugopal, Attorney General of the Government of India, they disassociated themselves from this part of the report, when this New Delhi Center report was being finalized, they disassociated themselves. I want to know the reasons for their disassociation. The government must speak out. Sir, now, so that it's come to clause 5 of the bill. Clause 5 of the bill. Clause 5 of the bill says, the center, this New Delhi center, shall consist of the following members. A, a person who has been a judge of the Supreme Court or a judge of a high court, or an eminent person having special knowledge and experience in the conduct of administration. B, two eminent persons having substantial knowledge and experience in institutional arbitration. C, one representative from commerce and industry. D, secretary, Department of Law. E, one financial advisor, Department of Expenditure. And all of them will be appointed by the government. Will they be independent? Will they be neutral? This is the question. Whether investors who prefer arbitration proceedings from inside or outside, whether they will prefer this New Delhi arbitration or London Arbitral Tribunal or Hong Kong, or for that matter, Singapore, or even in Stockholm, they won't come to New Delhi. This is an eyewash, just to fulfill the commitment before the World Bank and to grab the property and the infrastructure of the ICICA, which was led by the Honorable Chief Justice of India. That has been taken over. And, sir, now, so it is essentially a Government of India Arbitration Center. Better to name it not New Delhi Arbitration Center, it is a Government of India Arbitration Center. There should not be any ambiguity thereafter. Totally manned, managed, and controlled by the government. Where is the investor-friendly procedural framework? Where is the transparent process for appointment and removal of the members? So if the bill in the present form is passed, the independence and credibility of the institution shall be compromised once and for all. Sir, so far the second bill is concerned, because I will abide by your direction and the time. Law Minister objected.
Sir,
sir, the Sri Krishna Committee recommended constitution of an independent body, which is in the objective but not in the provisions, which will provide recommendations and guidelines for growth of institutional arbitration in India. I am talking about the second bill. The key concerns are, it is not independent. That is the major concern. The Arbitration Council of India, as proposed under the bill, consists of only individuals nominated by the central government or ex officio members. Government is the biggest litigator in India. What was the suggestion of the Sri Krishna Committee? All the time it is called Sri Krishna Committee, High Power Committee, High Power Committee. What they suggested? Let us look at the recommendation of the Sri Krishna Committee. Sri Krishna Committee said, a retired judge of the Supreme Court of India or a high court who has substantial experience dealing with arbitration matters or has acted as an arbitrator nominated by the Chief Justice of India, he will be a member of the governing body of the Arbitration Council. That is the first recommendation of the Sri Krishna Council. Second, an eminent counsel, not eminent persons of government choice or of the minister's choice. An eminent counsel having substantial knowledge and experience in institutional arbitration, both international and domestic, nominated by the central government. Government will nominate only an experienced, eminent counsel having special knowledge in domestic and international arbitration. And what this bill says? This bill says, the council shall consist of the following members. a judge of the Supreme Court, all right. High Court, all right. Or an eminent person. In place of eminent counsel, government has replaced that.
Shame.
That an eminent person having special knowledge will be there. So, government has not accepted the recommendation of the Sri Krishna committee. It is a total departure from the recommendations of that committee. On the very first provision says that. It is crystal clear. Nobody can deny. And then, sir, an eminent arbitration practice. Then, eminent arbitration practitioner, second one. But in the first one, he has, the bill has provided that. And now, there is a secretary to the government of India will be the ex-officio member, all right. No problem. But 43, clause 43C, sub-clause 2, proviso, what it says, provided that no chairperson or member other than ex-officio member shall hold office as such after he has attained the age of 70 years in case of the chairperson and 67 years in case of member. So, ex-officio member, he can continue up to 70 years and others up to 67 years. And who is the ex-officio member? Ex-officio member is the secretary. And he can also be the chairperson. It is not that he will continue as a member. He can also be the chairperson, if so required, because in the definition clause, it is the member includes the chairman. So, we are being befooled. You are being befooled. All the time it is said, Sri Krishna committee, Sri Krishna committee. Sir, now, my question is, a government body that regulates arbitrators and arbitration is antithetical to the very concept of arbitration, whether it is a fact or not. As a legal practitioner, once upon a time I was a legal practitioner, not nowadays, sitting under a banyan tree, I used to practice law, not like the Honorable Law Minister or other senior members who are lawyers. So, a government body that regulates arbitrators and arbitration is antithetical to the very concept of arbitration, and for that reason has no precedent in any arbitration-friendly jurisdiction. India is the only exception if this bill is passed. Further, in a country where the government is the biggest litigant, it cannot act as a supervisor over the very arbitrators who are hearing cases against the government. There is a clear conflict of interest where an arbitrator is hearing a dispute involving the government if a body appointed by the government will also proceed to review grading of the arbitrator as has been envisaged in this bill. Therefore, sir, I strongly oppose this bill. Sir, the date of completion of the proceedings is not clearly identifiable date in all circumstances. For instance, where there is need for a preliminary award on jurisdiction, where proceedings are bifurcated for other reasons, or there is a counterclaim filed, or where a party amends its pleading, there is uncertainty. Second, an exemption for international commercial arbitration regimes. There is a time limit for the domestic arbitration, but for the arbitration, international arbitration, there is no time limit. So that will be an arbitration unto death. So far international arbitration is concerned, that will be an arbitration unto death. But so far domestic arbitration, there is a time limit. And that too is very unpractical. Sir, finally, the bill wishes to define the proceedings to which the amendments introduced on 23rd October 2015 will apply. In doing so, the bill seeks to overturn a recent decision of the Supreme Court, that is in the case of BCCI versus Cricket Coaching, Kochi Cricket Private Limited. And the Supreme Court, we expected that following the Supreme Court ruling, the government will pay a serious attention to the judgment, and accordingly the bill will be checked, which has not been done. And again, I say that this government has no respect, uncanny respect, for the Supreme Court or the High Court or the judiciary as a whole. And this bill, according to me, draconian bills, and in protest against the way the bill has been brought in this House without the scrutiny of the parliamentary committees, I stage a walkout.